Assalamu alaikum students, today we will start a new chemistry course named Organic Polymers. It is a course of BS Chemistry, 8th semester students. The first content of our course is the brief introduction to polymer chemistry. So, we will start it from very basic points. What is macromolecules? A giant size molecule, which is often a polymer, is called macromolecule. What does it mean, students? It means ek bahut bade size ka molecule jo polymer bhi ho sakta hai usko hum macromolecule kehte hain. Macro stand for bada. So classification of macromolecules comprised on two classes. One is the inorganic macromolecule, another is organic macromolecule. So, inorganic macromolecule like diamond, graphite and sand etc. While organic macromolecule are further classified into two classes, one is the biopolymer, another is synthetic polymer or man-made polymer. What is biopolymers? Biopolymers which are present in living cells like plants and animals. Example of the biopolymers includes lipid, protein, starch, cellulose, etc. While synthetic polymer or man-made polymer includes plastic, synthetic fiber, rubber, etc. And its example includes PVC, mean polyvinyl chloride, nylon 6,6, polystyrene and polyethylene, etc. Now students, what is polymer chemistry? Okay, the chemical modifications designed to improve the physical properties of naturally occurring polymers. What does it mean? It means that if we treated the natural polymer while using chemical, the natural polymer converted into the vulcanized natural rubber, its properties enhanced as compared to earlier ones. So this process is said to be vulcanization process and polymer chemistry based on it. So we will move towards the history. In 1939, a scientist named Charles Goodyear, he treated the natural rubber with sulfur and heat it and convert it into the vulcanized natural rubber. Via proceeding this process, the properties of natural rubber enhanced. It showed the elasticity over wide range of temperature, and this process like convert the natural rubber into vulcanized rubber is said to be the vulcanization process. And this process is used to improve the properties of natural rubbers. So, at the end of 19th century, the first synthetic fiber named rayon, chemical formula is C18H32O16, it used for textile purposes. And it was prepared from cellulose. Students, it's an important MCQs. Examiner can ask about it. What is the first synthetic fiber? So remember it. The name of first synthetic fiber is rayon. And what is its chemical formula? Its chemical formula is C18H32O16. And from where it prepared? It prepared from cellulose. So in 1910, a scientist named Leo Backlund, he introduced first totally synthetic polymer. Another MCQs. What is the name of first totally synthetic polymer? Its name is bakelite. And bakelite consists of two monomers. One is the phenol, another is formaldehyde. What is the name of scientist? The name of scientist is Leo Baekeland. He introduced first totally synthetic polymer named Baekelite. So, in 1920, a scientist named Hermann Staudinger, his hypothesis includes that polymers were high molecular weight compounds held together by normal covalent bond. And his hypothesis was supported by two another scientists. One is the Wallace Carothers and Irene DuPont. And at this point, the concept of polymerization is originated. Another interesting point, every year 250 billion pounds of organic synthetic polymers are produced. Remember it, students. Now, if I say we are living in plastic society, can you believe? Yes. You should believe it. We are living in plastic society. Now, I will tell you, and you should have to imagine it. We wear clothes made up of nylon and polyester. Yes. We walk on polypropylene made carpets. We drive cars with plastic fenders and polymer rubber made tires. We use artificial hearts made from silicone polymers. Our pens, computers, toys are made largely of polymers. So these are the interesting points, and just imagine it and feel it. So a question is, difference between polymers and macromolecules. All polymers are macromolecules, but all macromolecules are not polymers. For example, polyethylene, polystyrene, cellulose, these are all polymers as well as also are macromolecules. While chlorophyll, a macromolecule but not a polymer. Now students, we will able to define polymer. Before moving towards polymer, a point is, a polymer is a substance made or composed of macromolecules. So remember it also. So what is polymer? Poly stand, poly mean many, and mers mean units. A large molecule made up by the repetition of small and simple chemical units is called polymer. For example, a monomer name ethylene, CH2 double bond CH2. If we take n number of monomers of the ethylene and polymerize it, it will convert into a polymer named polyethylene. CH2 single bond CH2 and whole comprised n. It means it is a large molecule, and the naming of this molecule is polyethylene. The monomer is ethylene and polymer is polyethylene. Many monomers. Okay. So this was overall about today's topic. We have discussed the, yes, we have discussed its introduction, and we have started from the macromolecules, then classification, then polymer chemistry. Then we have seen it's the history and important points. Question, differentiate between the polymer and macromolecule. And lastly, we define the polymers. So we are going towards wrap our lecture. So thanks for watching. Share your feedback. Thank you.